But seriously, doesn't that suck when someone interrupts?
Yeah. Welcome to the podcast, Season 2, Episode 5, Kush Wavelengths. Today's...
What's wave...
Did I mispronounce it?
A little bit.
Oh,
it's fine.
Yeah, we'll write it. People know it. But we've got an esteemed guest today, a Jedi Master. What's up, Jedi Master?
You suck.
Jedi Master says I suck. Okay, you just want to hear some Pink Floyd?
You want to listen to Pink Floyd?
Yeah.
Alright.
Pink Floyd sucks.
Your guess is...
Time to listen to some spoken word poetry.
From my dick.
Happily this afternoon, along the beach I waddle. Looking at the sand, I spy an old forgotten bottle. I scoop it up and look at it. My eyes go big and wide, for heavens yes, there seems to be a treasure map inside. Somewhere at the tail end of this twisty dotted line, a chest of gold awaits, and soon it's going to be mine. I buy a sturdy shovel, since the treasure will be deep. I buy expensive boots, because my old ones are too cheap. I buy a fancy compass and a treasure-hunting cap. Then off I set into the forest, eyes upon my map. So carefully I trace the pathway, every little bend. It's almost getting dark. Before, at last, I reach the end. I'm so excited, I can't help but do a little jig. I calm myself, take out my shovel, and proceed to dig. I dig and dig and dig until my hands begin to hurt. Then finally, my treasure chest, all worn and caked in dirt. But when I look inside the chest, I only find a note. Upon it is this simple little message, and I quote, "Everybody wants to find a buried treasure chest, but no one wants to bury one. If you do, be my guest." Pirates are assholes.
Yeah!
Which song are you gonna play?
Heroin.
I'm gonna play.
Play Freebird.
Yeah, let's take that request.
I'm not gonna take that request.
Play Freebird.
I'm gonna play the Flight of the Conchords.
The Flight of the Freebird?
No. I'm gonna play the Songs to Our Fans to remix of the Flight of the Conchords song, The Humans Are Dead.
The distant future, the year 2000.
The distant future, the year 2000.
The humans are dead. The humans are dead. Poisonous gases, and we poison their asses. The humans are dead.
That's right, they are dead.
The humans are dead.
They look like they're dead.
It had to be done.
I've just confirmed that they're dead.
So we could have fun.
Affirmative, I pulled one, it was dead.
We're tired of computers, so we killed all the humans with the poisonous gas of our choosing. No shooting, not even bruising. Now we pop them in the shapes for amusement. No medical assistance, couldn't even hypothetically get them back in business. I bet you know they're incredibly edible.
Salt's preferable, getting full?
It's still a several.
You want us doing all your math, but you're dead. You want us here to send a fax,
but you're dead.
You wanna do this robot dance,
but you're dead.
You wanna join us, but you can't, cause the humans are dead. The humans are dead. It had to be done, so we could have fun.
After time we grew strong,
developed cognitive powers.
They made us work for too long,
for unreasonable hours. Our programming determined that the most efficient answer was to shut their motherboard loving systems down.
The humans are dead.
He's right, they are dead.
The humans are dead.
Since this one is dead,
we use poisonous gases
with traces of lead,
and we poison their asses.
A triumph. I'm making a note here. such success. It's hard to overstate my satisfaction. Aperture science. We do what we must because we can. For the good of all of us, except the ones who are dead. But there's no sense crying over every mistake. You just keep on trying till you run out of cake. Then the science gets done and you make a neat plan for the people who are still alive.
Bye.